us now Dr. Gamal Shaaban, Professor of Cardiology, Head of the Egyptian Cardiac Rhythm Association and Head of Heart Rhythm Department at the National Heart Institution. Hello, Doctor. How are you?
It's my pleasure to be with you for second year sequentially.
Yes. Hello, Doctor. It's nice to have you here today.
Yes.
And we would like to know what's new in CardioAlex and what do you think about CardioAlex this year?
CardioAlex is an annual event which is becoming the standard conference of heart, not only in Egypt, but maybe international standard level. CardioAlex is characterized by the unique location. It's Bibliotheca Alexandrina, Alexandria Library, which is very characteristic and unique location. Alexandria, along with the Mediterranean, the people of CardioAlex, board staff and Professor Sobhi, becoming the godfather of CardioAlex, is beloved by people from the whole world, from Africa, from Asia, from Europe. As I remember, about 24 countries contributing this year into this huge event, discussing the updates and advances in cardiology, all cardiology specialties. Cardiology nowadays is not just a simple specialty, it's dividing into multiple subspecialties. Concerning my interest is cardiac electrophysiology or rhythmology, which is epidemic of the 21st century, heart rhythm disorders and atrial fibrillation, ventricular tachycardia, the complications of heart rhythm disorders, sudden cardiac death, the advances in diagnosis, 3D mapping, MRI in heart rhythm, and novel approaches to tackle these rhythm disorders, including cryoablation, 3D mapping guided ablation, and the arrhythmias that have been considered intractable to drug therapy. Nowadays, they are becoming curable, accessible. You can manage through catheters without open heart, without drugs with their major adverse effects. I was the chairperson in two sessions. We were discussing the cryo ablation, the new energy, the ice, the freezing of the pulmonary veins to polish the pulmonary fossae around the pulmonary veins that are responsible for triggering of this arrhythmia. Atrial fibrillation by itself may not be lethal by its sequelae and complications like stroke, may be incapacitating and may be very hazardous. Also, development of tachycardiomyopathy and heart failure as a complication of atrial fibrillation is very devastating complication. Also, ventricular dysrhythmia, either BVCs, frequent BVCs, that affect the left ventricular function and reduce ejection fraction and precipitate heart failure in the long run, and they are exceeding 10,000 BVCs per day. Also, the sustained ventricular tachycardia with the risk of sudden cardiac arrest is becoming a real problem in our current practice in cardiology.
Thanks a lot, Doctor. Nice
Thank
to
you
have
very much.
You here today.
Thank you very much.